Antilatency devices use a proprietary radio protocol to transmit data. The protocol operates on the 2.4 GHz frequency. It is optimized for real-time performance and has low latency while transmitting data. For data transmission, you can set an access point to work on any of the 141 provided radio channels, ranging from 2360 to 2500 MHz. A lot of devices using the 2.4 to 2.5 GHz band will create network interference with the anti-latency radio protocol. The main source of radio noise is 2.4 GHz wireless internet due to its widespread use and relatively high signal strength. By default, anti-latency devices choose one of these five channels due to their low noise levels. To select the optimal radio channels, we recommend scanning the 2.4 GHz range in the tracking area using the RadioScan utility. RadioScan will help you picture real-time noise levels on all radio channels. To prepare for launch, you can download RadioScan from our website. For best results, we recommend using a universal radio socket in conjunction with a bracer or a tag for a radio test. Place your devices 1 to 2 meters apart. Make sure that there are no interfering objects between them, especially those that can carry static electricity. If possible, exclude all external factors that can influence device operation because test results may vary depending on the channel. Turn on the universal radio socket and limit the number of connected devices using the CON limit property. Turn on the bracer or the tag and wait till it connects to the universal radio socket. Close anti-latency service before launching RadioScan. Open the console and access the folder with radioscanner.exe. Create a folder to store the scan results. Run RadioScan and set the path to save test data. Run one or two more scans in this location. Then, change the test location and repeat the test. In this example, we used non-conductive material to prevent the accumulation of static electricity from the carpet. For a good result, we recommend running scans in the corners of the location. The more scans you run, the better will be the picture of your radio environment. RadioScan changes channels and saves the number of errors in radio packet transmissions per run. One scan will take approximately 12 minutes. To analyze the results, group them in a summary table. This command creates a file named scan.txt. A convenient way to analyze these results is using a spreadsheet application. The results of three scans may look as follows. The number in the cell shows how many packets out of roughly 10,000 packets were lost. Channels 0 to 40 and 122 to 140 will be almost loss-free because wireless networks do not use them. For this example, channels 41 to 66, 77 to 85, and 100 to 121 are the best choices for connections. Channels 67 to 76 and 86 to 99 appear to be unstable with a lot of packet loss. The distance between the selected channels must be at least 6 MHz. After determining the optimal radio channels, you can start configuring sets of radio devices. You can read more detailed instructions on our website.